You ready for the new season of Real World?
Yeah, I hear it's going to be pretty good this year.
Same. I can't wait to see if we know anybody.
This is the true story of the CSD faculty. Is it hot in here? Big to work in. French East. Woot woot! And have our lives taped. Nancy! Then find out
what happens when people
stop being polite.
Ba, ba, ba.
And start being real.
Put your fingers on your buzzers and let's dance.
Good shit.
The Real World CSD faculty!
I'm Sandra Combs, and can we cut for a second? I need to do something with this background. It's much better. Okay. Well, I mean, I'm pretty rare bird, pretty social butterfly. I mean, I'm not that rare because I have a twin sister. She actually works right over there. And even though I changed my hair color based on whether or not my team won or lost that week, I mean, I just think it would be hilarious if someone was like walking over there and said hi to me because you thought it was me and it was actually her. And I just like ignored them, but it's really her. That'd be hilarious.
Okay. So why would you make a great person for this show?
Well, I mean, it's kind of a big deal. It's not really it's a big deal. But Dr. Hugh Katz knows me by my boots. I have lots of shoes, and the world needs to see my shoes.
Okay. So what makes you come to work every day?
Well, my lecture material is pretty awesome. You know, if a student answers a question, and then that same student answers another question, I'm like, hey, they're shooting for two, because I love some UK basketball, so I like to throw that in there. Another reason why I love to come to school is Dr. Kretschmer. He's awesome. He's awesome. Oh, wait, is he here? He's right here. Right here.
Do I have to do this interview with her?
Yeah.
Oh, Kretsch.
All right, so your name is... What again?
My name's Richard Kretschmer.
Well, I have this question real quick. So what's the difference? And I've been thinking of this for a while. It's been a conundrum of mine. I have this plethora of questions I need to ask you. So what's the difference if a baby goes like, huh? Or if they go, huh, with a smile?
Just go search for it on Google. I just don't want to talk about this.
Oh,
right
come
now.
On.
You can search for it on Google.
Okay. So, Dr. Kretschmer.
Wait, so I have to start over because you had a technical difficulty?
No, we're just going to continue from where we left off.
It's a bunch of nonsense.
Yeah, I'm sorry about
that. Is this my fault or is this yours?
Oh, no, it's completely our fault. It would never be your fault.
Right.
Okay, so go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, like I said, my name's Richard Kretschmer. I used to be a professor at UC. I'm not going to miss teaching that much. I like American Girl dolls and observing children at the zoo. Parents kind of think I'm a creep. I'm just observing their behavior, you know.
All right. So what's your favorite thing to talk about?
Oh, ba, 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 mama,
Just in case I do get picked for this, I mean, which shoes exactly do you think I should bring? You know, maybe these, you know, the wedges, or I got the heels too, or boots. I mean, I have a lot of shoes, so I can pretty much go with anything.
Okay, Dr. Combs, we'll let you know.
My name is Susan Givler.
Okay, can you tell me a little bit more about yourself? What do you like to do?
I love the schools. Everything about the schools. I worked in the schools for decades, and I love the schools.
So, what makes you come to work every single day?
The students. The students need my help. Because let's be honest, they all go and work in the schools. All of them. So, they're going to need me to help guide them in schools.
Okay. Okay, and I'm already assuming I know what the answer to this question is, but what's your favorite thing to talk about?
Oh, IEPs. For sure, IEPs. And you know what? I'm teaching my students right now about parent-friendly language, all right? None of this SLP jargon. And I swear, if somebody uses fricative, I'm gonna be frickin' mad.
Hey, Nancy, what time is it?
It's peanut butter protocol.
It's peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. Way at, way at, way at, way at. There you go, there you go, there you go, there you go.
Oh my gosh, I don't even know what to say. Who do I need? Like a good neighbor, Miss Breen is there.
Hi, Katie. What's the problem?
I don't know what to say to my supervisor. What do I do?
Don't worry. I can help you. In my office.
Okay. Oh my gosh, Miss Breen, that's so well written. Thank you so much. I knew I could count on you.
Are your students falling asleep in class?
Is nobody listening to you?
Well, we've got the thing for you.
Soapbox! For just 20 easy payments of $19.95.
It'll help you keep sidetracked in class.
Enough to annoy your students.
And when you whip this baby out, your students will actually listen to you.
But wait! There's more! Double the size of your soapbox for just 10 more payments of $19.95.
I can't believe it!
Soapbox!
My name is Sue Schmidlin. And I take care of the clinic, keep it organized.
Okay, so why would you be a great person for this reality show?
Well, I come prepared. Like today I brought my own microphone. Hello? Can you hear me?
I think you need to turn it around, maybe?
Okay.
There we go.
Can you hear me now? Anyone? Okay.
Okay, so what is your favorite thing to talk about?
What's your favorite thing to talk about?
It varies. I mean, I like sports.
Okay. Well, I like to have open-ended conversations with everyone. I like sports too, like the Reds.
Oh, okay. We'll go ahead and start off with your name and a little bit about yourself.
That's a good question. I am Dr. Lindsay Riegler, and I started my education out at OU, but then I came here to UC, where I got my PhD. I now work in the Veterans Affairs over here at the VA, but if any of you are from OU, please let me know, because I like to stay on top of the know, and I'd like to know any new bars that are in Athens.
Okay, so what makes you a good candidate for this show?
Oh, well, I'd like to say that that's a good question. And I think at any time, because of my VA experience with PTSD and stuff, I'm ready for war. So this show, I would be ready for anything.
Okay, sounds good. So do you have any scare tactics when it comes to talking to your students?
That's a really good question. Let's see here. I don't know if I'd like to scare them, but it's kind of funny, actually. I didn't show up to the final exam, and so it was just sort of like, any questions, give them to Tori. She can answer. But I warned them. I told them, if you start studying 2 weeks before the exam, you will not pass. Like, you have to study before that. Are you catching what I'm throwing down?
Yeah, I get it. And so what's your favorite thing to talk about?
That's a really good question. Anything besides my personal life, I don't talk about anything. If people ask me a question about, you know, what's going on at home, no, I don't talk about that. Anything other than my personal life, I'll talk about.
Okay, I think that about wraps up the interview.
Hey, is Dr. Pete here? Because I wanted to know, we share pictures, and sometimes I show the picture first, he shows the picture second, but I mean, I just wanted to know.
How y'all are?
Hey, I'm fine, thank you. Did you show them the one picture that, I'll email it to you.
Dr. Pete, I'm a Navy man, born and bred. If you can't get down with that, we're not gonna get along. It's just how it is. You're my shipmate. Are you shitting me, shipmate? Another technical difficulty? I need you to look harder at the buttons to work the camera.
All right, so I'm sorry about that. This has been happening a lot recently. So what is your favorite thing to talk about?
Well, see, I know everything that I need to know about me. You guys don't know everything you need to know about me. So the only thing I really need to know is how y'all are.
Okay. So what would make you a good fit for this show?
Well, this is the show where they get in the hot tub late at night with all the ladies, right? The Real World, this is the one?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, well, simple. It's an easy transition. I've been in the water with female mammals my whole life, swimming with them, aquarium to aquarium. This coffee right here will keep me up late. I'll be good to go.
Do you have any scare tactics when it comes to scaring your students?
Oh, it's simple. The gunner questions on the quizzes. If they don't know those, they can just get the hell out.
Right here? Make sure you sit right here. Okay, hi! My name is Phyllis Breen. I'm the practicum supervisor here at UC. I place the students at their different practicum sites. You tell me where, and I'll put you there. This show, I'm not really sure what it's all about. I'm not really into the whole social networking. Facebook, I just kind of leave that to my students. I'm good at a supporting role. When my students come to me, they have meltdowns. I'm just like a motherly figure to them. I love to give hugs. I'm really organized, so I could be good. I like to make calls, so maybe more behind the scenes kind of role. And in terms of scare tactics, I don't consider myself scary at all. I'm just nice, I'm really nice. And I like to give hugs. So I think that's all you really need to know about me, but I gotta get some emails taken care of, so I'm just gonna head out, okay?
My name is Dr. Leslie Reiserbecker. Well, yes, that's my name. So what else? What else do you wanna know?
Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I love cats. See, I love cats. It actually reminds me of this one story where I had a cat and he actually fell out the window. Oh my god, it was horrible, but you know what? It's okay
because my husband was there and he caught it and it was okay, but then, and my husband the other day, you know what he told me? He told me that this cleaning stuff is just not organic and it's really bad, but then my friend said the same thing too. And I just don't understand why people are freaking out about everything.
Okay, we'll just go on to why you think you would be a good contestant for the show.
Well,
that reminds me of this one time where I was Patrick Swayze and I was at this party when I was in fifth grade and I was trying to lift up everyone and everyone really wanted me there because I was Patrick Swayze.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I think I could probably do that at the house. I could just lift everybody up.
Okay, so it's Keiko, right?
Yes! Yes.
Where are you from?
My home? I'm from here. This is my happy place.
What? Oh, you have technical difficulties? It's okay. I get it all the time.
Yeah, sorry about that. So, again, why would you be a good candidate for the show?
Yes. Well, I love everyone. I love my students. I just love my students. So, I'd be good for the show.
Okay. So, do you happen to have any scare tactics when it comes to teaching?
Yes. Want to see a picture? I tell my students, do not drink coffee, no cigarettes, no marijuana. Want to see a picture?
No, I think we're good.
People hang on his every word, even the prepositions. He could disarm you with his looks or his hands, either way. He can speak French in Russian. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always send emails, but when I do, I send 50. Wait, what? In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room, and the endlessness that you fear.
Okay, well, my name is Dr. Carla Washington. I am a professor here at the University of Cincinnati. I was born in Jamaica, that's why I wear this t-shirt. I have 2 ASHA awards. Some people my age, they don't even have 1 ASHA award because I am good at everything that I do. I have an award for, have you heard of my research? Have you heard of the research that I've done? It's amazing. I'm going to take over the world. You have to think bigger. Don't think small, just think bigger, big dreams. I'm going to take over the world. We're going to rewrite all of the textbooks. Yeah, that's what I'm good.
Yeah, I'm sorry. So, what is it that you do as a scare tactic for your students?
Well, I really don't scare my students. Actually, I don't know what they do. They always like daydreaming.
So, the ICFCY. Are you listening to me? This is not a rhetorical question. The ICFCY. So the ICFCY. Well, never mind my awards, because the ICFCY.
Let me tell you about CYFYC.
I'm sorry, I had the questions mixed up. It was on Facebook and they're on their laptops. And I'm not really sure because I stand in the front of the room, but when I walk around, I see them. I see them on their computer. You think I'm not watching? I'm watching you. I'm watching you.
I'm Dr. Amy Dietz.
Hi, and I'm Joe.
So what's your favorite thing to talk about?
My favorite thing to talk about is my research on AAC and aphasia.
And you, Joe?
My favorite thing to talk about is her research on AAC and aphasia.
Okay, and so what makes you come to work every day?
I have to check up on Joe and make sure he's doing the research, my research.
Okay, and what's your favorite scare tactic when trying to get the students to listen to you?
Well, I know in the past, my tests were a little too scary, I heard, so I had to make it online, but I made sure the students know that it's going to be hard and it's going to be really long, even if it's online.
And what makes you come to work every day, Joe?
Well...
Are you having a word-finding issue?
My name is Dr. Lisa Kelchner. You may have heard of me. I'm pretty important when it comes to anything that has to do with voice and swallowing. I love Seinfeld, but I don't think any of my students have heard about Seinfeld.
All right. So, why would you be a good candidate for the show?
Because I pretty much am very serious about everything. With, smoking, it's not good for your lungs. It dries out your larynx and your vocal folds. Just don't do it. And they think smoking weed's better. No, it's not. That's not filtered. If it was up to me, people, I would say, eat more cookies and brownies. Can I just say one more thing?
Sure.
If you guys have any questions, those could be directed to my TA, Hydea. And my students really just need to de-stress. So I think that they should watch Seinfeld.
Hi, my name is Krista Beyer, and to tell you about myself, I'm going to tell you four things. This is how I start every day with my students, to lighten the mood a little. So one thing about myself is that I love to whistle, and I whistle all the time. I know lots of different tunes. Another thing about myself is that pickles are my favorite food, and sometimes I even have pickle teenies. A third thing about myself is that I love astrology. And I read my horoscope every day. I was actually reading it right now before this interview. And the fourth thing about myself is that I hate the word groping. And I don't know why my students don't understand that it's articulatory groping, not groping. So it just makes me feel violated. And if you just say groping on a test, I will ding you for it. I think I would be a great candidate for this show because I love working with all types of people, whether they're preschoolers or whether they're adults. And I try to be really cool, I'm hip, I have a Twitter, you should follow me, and I make Facebook groups, and so yeah, I think I'd be a great candidate for the show.
Okay.
My name is Dr. Nancy Craighead. You've probably seen my name in some books. I'm kind of a big deal, and I really like peanut butter. I really like words that rhyme. Let's think about words that end in T. Cat, sat, shat. Gotta love that past tense.
Okay, so what's your favorite scare tactic when trying to get the students to listen to you?
Well, my students know that if they don't know the difference between Garrett and Hudson, that they're going to be terrible at their jobs.
And why would you be a good person for this reality show?
Well, I should probably start by mentioning that I know about twerking, so I'm really up with the times. Carney! Carney! Where's Carney? I need Carney!
Nancy!
What is this? What can Ono, President Ono, see this? What is this? What is this?
Just sit down, Carney.
I just love the weather today.
Really? I hate it.
Oh, me too.
I really need to have a staff meeting this week. People are going wild.
Oh, I can totally help you with that.
Carney, please.
Oh, okay. I'll email you about it.
Okay.
All right, so Carney, is it?
Yes, Dr. Okay. Carney Soto.
All right, so tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I am a Spee. I work here, and I like to do emails, and yeah, you're at UC.
All right. So what's your favorite thing to talk about?
I just love talking about my students and what they do, and I really like to email them at 2 or 5 in the morning, so people don't have the chance to respond right away.
And has anything ever come from that?
Oh, I don't think anybody has ever cried from one of my emails.
Another email from Soto. I don't even know. Oh my god. All the people in the house, put them on like.
Let's flip the track with the old school band.